Hi, I'm Michelle with Tennis Warehouse, and for this week's improved video, we wanted to dive into some more customizing and showing you how to increase the sweet spot on your racket and help with stability at impact. So I'm not very good at this stuff, so I brought Troy with me. He is an MRT. He's actually one of the most precise customizers that I know. So he is going to show you and take you through this process.
Yeah, so I'm pretty known for adding weight to my rackets. Today, we're going to focus on adding some weight up in the head of the racket at the 3 and 9 o'clock positions, which is basically at the sides of the hoop here. So think of it as a clock, 3 and 9 or 9 and 3, however you look at the racket. But adding weight here, as Michelle said, is going to help increase the stability of the racket, especially on off-center contact. And then you're also going to bump up your swing weight. Anytime you put weight up in the hoop, it's going to give you more swing weight, more power, more plow through. So I have a pack here of the Tennis Warehouse tungsten tape, really handy, good way to add weight to your racket. So I'll go ahead and dive into that and put some weight on this Babolat racket here. So the tungsten tape, it comes in three strips. Each one of them is 3 grams, so you have a total of 9 grams with the tungsten tape here. For today's purposes, I'm going to use 2 strips total, one on each side of the hoop. So one on the 3 o'clock and one on the 9 o'clock. And basically taking the tungsten tape here, it's got an adhesive back. To find your 3 and 9 o'clock position on the racket, this has 20 crosses, so I could just count down here. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And this area right here is gonna be about the center of the side of the hoop. So what I'll do from there is I'll take the center mark here, line it up with the middle of the tungsten tape labeled with the TW symbol, and basically lay it up against the frame. And it'll stick to the hoop. And this will give me some added weight to one side of the frame, like that. And then I will go ahead and take another strip and add it to the opposite side of the hoop on the other side of the string plane. Since today I'm just using 2 long strips, you can also cut them in half and do 4 strips, which would be one on each side of the string plane for the racket. So basically just following the starting point on over to the other side of the hoop here, right about there. Since they're pre-cut to the same distance, if I start at the top and work my way down, I'm gonna have a pretty even amount of weight on both sides. And that's gonna provide a lot more mass, plow through, and torsional stability on the racket.
Awesome. So that's just such an easy way to customize your racket in such a small way and just take your game to another level. So thanks so much for showing us how to do that. If you guys want to learn more about how to improve your game and your gear, be sure to head to tenniswarehouse.com and click on the Improve tab.